This thing costs $8. What's up, guys? It's me, Jim. A lot of you probably don't know who this is. In fact, almost all of you don't know who this is. The only people that do are the people that have been directed from me to this channel or have seen some of my old videos. And those are, you know, the ones that do have views were it actually had time put into them or doesn't matter. Really good tagging, doesn't matter. The reason you're seeing a video on this channel at all is because I plan to reboot it for like the fourth time. Each time I've rebooted this channel, it's been for a different reason. It's either for I reboot it because I think I'm gonna make videos, I have a new video idea, or it's because I get some new kind of equipment. The last time I rebooted the channel, it was because I got a new piece of equipment. I bought a cheap ass piece of shit, where the hell is it? Piece of crap GoPro. I mean, this thing was $80. Okay, for my purposes, it was perfect. But the problem was when I realized I didn't have time to make videos with it, then that idea got scrapped. And it got scrapped pretty well because there hasn't been any uploads on the channel for like 3 or 4 months. But it doesn't matter to you anyway because you didn't see them. There was a couple reasons I decided to reboot this channel. One of which was because I had an idea for a new channel. So it would give me an excuse to completely redo the channel, all the artwork, everything like that. Another reason was because I didn't feel like giving up on something that I spent a lot of time on, especially when people still commented on today. Whether it's for a video I made recently or one I made 3 years ago, it's upsetting to see people still commenting on my videos and asking when the next one's going to come out. Final reason I decided to reboot this was because I need to have an excuse to stop falling asleep. I need to stay busy. My problem is I've started slacking recently. And at the beginning of the year, everyone knows that at the beginning of the year of high school or any grade that you are in or even college, you do really, really well for the first couple weeks, even couple months. And then all of a sudden, your work ethic decides to take a little bit of a dip and it just keeps going. Okay. It senioritis for seniors, collegeitis, I don't know. It doesn't matter. The point is, you stop working as hard, okay? You lose the motivation to do things. And I don't feel like doing that. I saw an extreme dip in what I started to do. I was doing really, really well in school. My grades have gone down a bit. I've started sleeping more. I've lost any kind of, you know, time schedule for sleeping. It's ridiculous. I need to fix it. And I came up with an idea on how I can fix it. And believe it or not, it's to clean this room. That sounds really stupid, but let me hit you with some cinematic shots real quick. You and I can both tell that this room looks like shit, okay? There is no sense of organization. There is absolutely no care taken of the room. It looks terrible. It needs to be redone. It needs to be cleaned. And the problem is I just don't have time to do it. That's not true. The time I have had to do it, I've spent sleeping. And instead of sleeping, I could be cleaning the room or keeping myself occupied and busy. I need to get back in the groove of working, so what better way to do it than fix my room to make it something look nice and make it look good and make it functional? And the word functional brings me to something. You see, functional, I like functional things. I like things that work. They don't necessarily need to be pretty, but as long as they work, I don't care. For instance, the camera that you're watching on right now, this camera is nowhere near pretty. It's got a cheap wide angle lens on it with a hacked bitrate Lumix camera that I only got because I could get the body really cheap and then buy prime lenses that don't focus for like $30 off eBay. It works. Not great, but it works. I especially love it when I figure something out to make something work the way I want it to, not necessarily the way it was intended by when you originally bought the product. So what this entire series is going to be, or next few videos anyway, before I, you know, figure out what I really want to do with the channel, is fixing this room. I don't know what I'm going to call the channel yet. Project something? I don't really know. And to be honest, project sounds kind of cheesy because, well, it's like Project Runway. Who gives a shit? Each video that I make after this is going to be how to do something, or it's going to be me fixing something in my room that needs to be fixed. Now, a lot of the things on my channel, if you watch someone named Casey Neistat or Neistat, I don't know how to pronounce his last name. I should, because I watch enough of his videos. But he makes really, really good videos. I love him so much. You know, his entire studio. Go look him up on YouTube. I'll put a link in the description. His studio is so incredibly organized. I mean, it looks like a mess at first glance. But then once you actually look at it, and he has a whole video on a presentation on it, it's so incredibly organized and functional. It blows my mind. Almost everything in there is built. He bought it for cheap or whatever. His desk that he works on and half the stuff that he shows it's from an old door or something. I mean, he got it for like $8 at a junkyard. Like, that's perfect. Like, I mean, you even could go as far to say that's roadkill. I'm guessing people know what roadkill is. Just type in roadkill on YouTube, you'll find it. Looks great, it has a very interesting aesthetic to it, and it's the kind of aesthetic that I look for. He also is very similar to me in terms of filming. You see, Casey and I come from very similar backgrounds. While he started from absolutely nothing and made something for himself, I've started from, well, a little bit more and haven't gone anywhere. I would like that to change. I have a lot of equipment that I've acquired over the years of making films since I was a little kid. Just like him, I found an editing software. Instead of iMac, it was Adobe Premiere, some very cheap early version of it. And I had a little Kodak camera I got for a birthday present. There's probably gonna be a story on that later, but that doesn't matter. Got a camera, started making videos. They were really horrible, shown to the family. Family loved them. I still have them on DVD, and they have been being used as blackmail since. Point was, ever since then, I have always been making videos. I make videos for school. I make videos for other people. And the thing is, I love doing it. I spend way too much time doing it. I spend overnighters all the time, and then I laugh about it later. And in the midst of all this, I'm failing school. But it doesn't matter because I made a really, really good 6-minute film. One of these sayings that people say all the time is, live your life doing something you love and you'll never work a day in your life. The only problem is that's very, very hard to do in filming. For the people that are successful in YouTube, it doesn't matter so much because they do make a good amount of money doing it. Casey, on the other hand, has a company, the company Beam that he's making, and he's making money off that. So he has two sources of income. And then he's also living with his wife, who I'm guessing works. Some of the things he does in his films are very, very creative, and I wanted to add them to my repertoire of filming tricks and tips and shots and whatnot. He and I aren't too different. However, we are different in the way we make films. But there are a couple of things that he's done that I've watched from his videos that I would like to emulate. Obviously not do the same thing as him, because, well, that's just copying. There's nothing interesting about that. So, most likely, at the same time that this video is going up, another video is going to be on my channel. It's going to be how to add a second keyboard to your computer. I'm going to upload that because that is the first video I want to make for this channel, and I will explain the logistics behind it and whatnot. It'll be a good video. If you think that it is too much like Casey's videos, if you are seeing that from his channel and it might have been a related video because of tags, tell me what you didn't like about it, please, because I'd like to improve on making videos, okay? I've gone through the reins of YouTube, I know how it works, so if you don't comment, that means the video wasn't interesting, okay? So if it's not interesting, comment anyway. If you've gotten this far, comment. I'm not asking for likes, just comment. Let me know what you think. Quick side note, I can't find anything in this damn room, okay? The only reason that this is here is because I couldn't find the micro SD card that went to my Zoom microphone. This thing is amazing. It's got a little windscreen on it. I love it so much. The only problem is it's completely useless when you don't have an actual micro SD card. I can't record audio on it. So I had to take this big ass microphone that I had for, you know, when I used to record gaming videos and drag it all the way over here with a giant micro USB cable. And it just fits long enough to the point where it wraps around me, and if I move back, it will completely rip the cord out. Okay, it looks terrible. It looks terrible on camera, but it's all I had, so I'd rather give you this audio instead of some POS camera audio. But like I said, the other thing that I can't stand is the fact that it looks like crap and it doesn't function. I'd be fine with it if it looked like crap and I could find everything. I can't find anything. Anyway, guys, that's all I got for